So exciting to do something cultural together.
Matt Groening, what's he doing in a museum? He can barely draw.
No!
Oh, no! I'm being erased!
Move it, bub. We got an installation to installate.
Are you ready? Are you ready? For the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble!
Norman.
You can get it jumping. You can get it pumping. You can get it pressing a suit.
A hard-earned thirst needs a big cold beer. And the best cold beer is Vic. A long cold Vic.
It's so hard to have a gay time on your own. It could be that great chalk and biscuit coating. Could be that smooth toffee ice cream in the center, or that whole delicious golden K-time taste.
I'm Danny, and I'm here to call out all you crack pack bitches. You think I don't see you there? I'm the OG of this shit. But you come after the king, you better come correct. I'm Danny, motherfucker. Who are you, crack pack? You smoke crack, you better watch your back.
Welcome, everybody, to the show. Rob, do you ever dance like that? I know you're a bit of a club dude.
Oh, back in the day.
You would have, like, trousers on with a shirt that's kind of undone down to your middle of your chest.
Dude, I single-handedly brought in sweatbands to clubbing.
Oh,
I remember
God.
It. Yeah.
I remember. That is not an accomplishment.
I remember I was at McDonald's and I wore it there and I'm like, yeah, we're going out clubbing later. And the guy's like, that's ridiculous. Why are you wearing a sweatband on your arm? And then 2 weeks later, Bancroft, he came back up to me and apologized. And he said, you're right.
Sumo Thori says, keep us out of your Rob fantasies, Bancroft. All right. Yeah. We didn't gather here to celebrate Rob's clubbing glory days. Citizen Rainer says, Backer is responsible for glow sticks. No, I never was a clubber, but I did go to a Chemical Brothers show once. And that was amazing. Michael Deacher says, once again, it falls to Rob to salvage a stream. It is true. It is true. We are here for the art share. It's my week this week. More of a journey, a story. Although Rob did very well. I will tip my hat to Rob. You did do very well last week. I really did enjoy the selection. It's back to me this week. Thank you so much for hanging out with us here tonight. We have... we are up against some big shows tonight. 23 people here on YouTube, but we do have 5 over on Rumble. Yo-Yo Fopeezy. How many do you see?
44, 45.
Yeah, it's because there's people watching on Twitter as well. Or at least they see it on Twitter. I don't know if they're watching, but that number will just tick up. It's crazy. It's a whole new thing. It'll like get up to like 300 or something like that, and I have to keep – you have to hover over it to see the YouTube numbers.
Oh.
But that's okay. We are here as Sequential Treasures to see. Let's see some cock art, and cock art we shall show. But before we do any of that, let's honor who is here in the chat. Llama Gigante coming in, flaunting the rules, as he always does, dancing the dance llama. Bretsky the Great, though, he got in the first, so we will honor him tonight. Where's my brand, actually? Oh, my goodness. In disarray here. Let's put that back up there. There we go. Looks a bit better now. Llama Gigante, third for the year. Fopeezy over on Rumble says, Bancroft, how in the hell did you manage to lose a subscriber from a few weeks ago? I don't know. Rumble is just no more Rumblers. It's like we got to 666 and we couldn't go any higher. And now we've even lost a couple. No, we're down to 665. Yeah, we lost one. So,
oh, okay. What's the Rumble address?
it's linked, it's pinned there in the chat. Obviously, if you want to get me back to 666, you know what to do. Who else we got here? We have Jeremy Burtz. Hail, Jeremy Burtz, Sequential Treasures, ready for the show to begin. Citizen Ronan might actually appear in the show tonight. So it's great to have him here in the chat. We got Jeff Starler here in the Steadfast. Duck Bacon's in the house. Phil Sydney Sweeney Diaz. The man is obsessed. Obsessed with Sydney Sweeney.
Well, and, I mean,
two big assets.
Why not?
You know, I introduced her to him, and now he's in love. I feel like I'm a matchmaker. We got this guy in the chat. Hail Mo Biggs here on time. He said, yeah, if he could make it here on the time switch, I better be on time. You guys have put your clocks forward or backward or something. And yeah, now we have to stream at a different time. But considering I'm up against Ethan every single night now, I might even consider moving again. It's getting ridiculous, Rob. It's getting more ridiculous out here in the streets. It used to be back in the day, you would stream late to avoid the primetime shows. And now you've got to stream early.
It's annoying. It's like they follow you around.
We've got to deal with it. That's okay. I don't mind it intimate and ugly, though. It works for me. Gary G in the house. Sumo Thori, who else do I spy? 40% Zed. I see Edwin's here. And Phil says, what? You're constantly messaging me about her. I don't know what you're talking about, Phil. What do you mean? I'm constantly sending you Sydney Sweeney images. Who would do such a thing?
Just share the DMs publicly, Phil.
I won't be llamaphobic, Llama Gigante. I will play you this because it seems like it doesn't matter how many times I play it, you don't understand the rules.
I may be down, but I'm not out. Tom Brady's never out. You broke the rules. You have broke the rules. You breaking the rules. You broke the rules. You broke the rules. How you found out I broke the rules? Yeah, you broke the rules. I'm convinced that I can break the rules because you guys broke the rules before. But I didn't bust you.
Time change madness. Yeah. Jake says his stream time is perfect. Him, look, I don't know what I'm gonna do once Painted Death is done. I'm gonna be a bit more flexible. Nothing's gonna change for the time being. I'm just so focused on the book. So we're just going full stream ahead, but yeah, we'll see what we do a bit later on. Both Rob and Michael should get mohawks. Rob doesn't even have a mohawk anymore,
he's just got a tuft
of hair on the top of his head.
How much in super chats would it take for you to get a mohawk, Mike?
I work, Rob. I go into an office. I have to deal with real people in real life.
And? Wear a hat.
Peter Gilmore in the house says, what a gorgeous pair of colonials. Thank you so much, Peter. From the motherland there. Rob never had a mohawk, he had a Rob hawk. Correct. Almost a faux hawk.
Man, England's getting crazy over there, Peter. What's going on? You can't say anything or you go to jail, pretty much the same as these days, Mike.
It's the same here. What are you talking about?
Is it? I don't think it's bad. It probably
is. We would read out some of the stuff that people write in the chat. We would go to jail as well. That is true. $5. Thank you so much, Jake Martin, for the Mohawk Fund.
Mm-hmm.
I'll put my hair up in a, you know, a thing like that if you want. But that's about the extent of it. I don't think Mel would appreciate the. I don't think she would like that. I just like how Eric Weathers' wife put the kibosh on the mullet. Now that was a shame, but we're dealing with it. I just sent out an update, but I don't think anyone's received it yet. Or if they have, I haven't received mine. But I just sent out an update on where we're up to with the book, just very quickly. So you all know I failed miserably in getting the 24 pages colored, but I got about 90% of it done, which I think is pretty good. I got close and was worried about it as I was before than I am now. But there's still about 19 pages that are sitting at about between 80 and 90% done. I think I'll be able to knock them out in a week or two. I was kind of pulling my hair out, coloring every day until midnight for a month. That was a hard slog. So I'm back onto line art. I got a few things to fix up there, mostly done. That'll be all done today. And then I got to jump into a double page spread that I've been putting off, but I've been visualizing it in my mind. And I think I know exactly what it's going to look like now. So I'm just going to jump into that. It's going to have buildings in it. It's sort of a bit of a reflection of what you're seeing here on the cover. Not quite exactly the same, but sort of like that. So it could take a little while. I'm giving myself about 2 weeks to finish that. Joe is working on the final edits on the script at the moment. So once that's done, Eric will start the letters. I've talked with him. He's ready to go. It's all happening, Rob. It's we're getting to the end. Always listen to your wife when it comes to your hair. They don't want to be embarrassed. I know. Women
aren't you divorced? Aren't you divorced, Henry?
Is he? Maybe he's speaking from experience. Women think that men are a reflection of them. The men that they choose are a reflection of them out there in public, and they take that stuff seriously.
I mean, we went to the beach yesterday, Mike. And there's guys wearing budgie smugglers. And I'm just like, how? Why? How do you get that?
Everything old is new again. The 80s are back. Thank you to everyone who's backed. We're up to, we've passed 500. So we're 69,525. And also getting close to 900 backers, which would be very cool as well. So, yeah, exactly. Why do you think you got divorced?
Mike, I don't know how you run your art chairs, but with mine, I actually like to show off some art.
We're getting to it.
Just throwing that out there.
It's been very hot these last couple of days, so things are moving a little bit slowly.
What do you call
a budgie smuggler?
What do they call them over there?
Speedos. But Speedos are an Australian invention, so we get to name them whatever the hell we want. A budgie, as in a budgerigar. Budgerie, that's what it is, isn't it?
Yes.
Is a small bird that you keep in a cage in your house. And it when you wear Speedos, it looks like you're smuggling, you know, a bird in your pants. So that's why they're called budgie smugglers. Or some of us, it's like a falcon smuggler. You know what I mean? Plum smugglers. Not a banana hammock. Is it a banana hammock?
I don't know.
I thought that was different. Anyway. And we have Australia to thank for Speedos. Not surprised. Yes, yes. Yeah, they're called budgie smugglers there too. Who would wear budgie smugglers in the UK?
There's one of the things I found so fascinating when I lived over there is like any time the sun comes out, multitudes of people just go to the park and sunbake. I'm like, I've never seen that in Australia.
Yeah, it was like 16 degrees Celsius. Yeah. And the Germans are out there in short shorts, topless. Okay. People are demanding to see art. I've got art for you. I do like to start with the Draughtism. I got a few of them. And one of them was shared with me. This one we've met before. This is Rachel Peace. She's a bit of a Draughtist alumni, a bit of a Draughtist art. She likes the trees. She's doing a technique here I've never seen before, which is
drawing.
No. It's all this detail, and she does it with the pen, but then she just wipes it with her finger, which is risky when you put all this detail into it, but it works for her. So look at this. She dabs it.
I think she might have oversold that, Mike.
What?
It was a dab. It wasn't a wipe. I mean,
I know. I thought it was a wipe. Yeah, there is a difference. You're right. But she does. These pieces are massive. They are 2 meters by 2 meters. So the Draughtism extends far beyond this example here. So
that's amazing. I wish we could see more of it, though.
We will. You want to see amazing? This one was shared to me by The Don. And he said, this Draughtism is on a kaiju scale. And you can see right here, it really is. Let's hit play here. It looks like a gray lead pencil piece. That's pretty epic. Is it not?
Yeah, it is amazing. I just don't get this movie. I just don't get it. I don't get the appeal of it. I just don't understand it.
Well, I don't get into it either, but I appreciate the artistry of it. I know. I tried to get Mel to watch the new one. She's not interested at all. Sumo says, Bancroft learned the hard way that wiping stuff with your fingers can be dirty. Jake Martin agrees that is epic. Truly.
It's impressive.
Yeah. I hope he sells that for a lot of money. A lot of work went into that.
Is he really drawing it, though, Mike? It looks like he's not even touching the paper.
It's called subtlety, Rob. A piece like that with kind of it looks foggy. You've got to be a master of subtlety. Mm. It's something you haven't really been too familiar with. But so last week we shared I think it was Jean Girard Galactus. Mm. And it was very cool. We both liked it. Was a week before, actually. We both liked it. We thought it was epic. It was a very highly detailed Mobius Galactus. Well, Skip Edwards has shared with me another piece from a different artist. And I think it's taking it to the next level.
I like how you haven't done any of the work for yours. Well, people are just sharing the art with you.
Yeah, exactly. Check this out. So this is an artist called, hang on a sec. Spaghetti-o. This is a Giorgio Comolo. And he has drawn a Galactus here out of what it looks like. It also could be pencils. I'm not sure, but you can see the Silver Surfer here. And it is just absolutely beyond. Look at all the little things down here. Is that his scraps that he's eaten? There's a little Captain America
Doom's
shield down
Doom's
there.
Doom's face, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool. Very cool.
Very
it's
cool.
Got a real Aztec kind of vibe to it.
Yeah. I checked out the rest of his art. It's all similar to this. It looks like he does these big epic pieces in this style where he just puts detail in every single space. Shadowpunk says, Comolo is a master. The spaghetti trick works every time. It does. Thank you, Mo, for helping. Peter Gilmore says, it's killing him that he's resting his hand on that pencil. Peter is a penciler extraordinaire himself. No one can stand up against Big Daddy G. Well, I'm just happy that Skip introduced him to me. So now we have a new Draughtist master into the ranks of Draughtism. Thank you. Hello to Art Bar. Welcome to the show. See how this number here, this live number, just keeps ticking up and ticking up? That's no, because people are scrolling through Twitter and see it, and each impression counts as a view. That's why I was getting confused. I'm like, what, 200 people are watching? That doesn't make sense.
It's great. I'm not ego that popular. Boost, though.
The guy, these guys here can't see it.
What happens if you just like leave the stream going for like?
I guess it would just, yeah, it would just keep ticking up. And I keep retweeting the tweet. That would happen. We do have 40, I think we have 40 something people watching on YouTube and 5 over on Rumble. So thank you everyone for hanging out. All right, let's continue on with the show. Again, more people sharing stuff with me. This is, we got Miss Marvel by Fred Bennis, She-Hulk by Mark Martinez, and Psylocke by Leo Matos. And he says, I think you'll notice a theme here. This was shared to me by nobody and no one. What do you think the theme is that this guy's into? Whoa.
I think he likes black. I think he's a fan of the color black and white.
That's what it is?
Yeah.
He likes the line art?
Yeah.
What kind of body shape do you call that? That's like...
Pear.
Yeah, but pear, but a ripe pear.
Very, very ripe pear. Yes.
Hello, John's Longbox. Thank you for sharing those with me. Nobody Nowhere showed them off. And thank you, everyone who's sharing art share stuff with me. It makes my job so much easier, including this fella here. John's Longbox actually shared this with me. This is a variant cover he got made for his Heroic Tales book upcoming by Pat Broderick, who is the artist on the much celebrated Bronze Star book. And obviously, I wasn't super familiar with Pat's work, but I loved his style on Bronze Star, which is a Western. Now we see it in a sort of a more superhero style. He's got some kind of giant bug here. And his superhero, the Patriarch. Remember we looked at the Patriarch last week or the week before? He was the one flying over the farm. And you assumed, because you assumed they were farmers.
Yes.
They weren't. They were his family, because you're a bigot.
Yes. He's the one with powers who wasn't doing any work while he was making his family work. I remember. That's right.
Yeah, that's
that was great. Yeah,
well, it's the Patriarch. He's the symbol of power. So excellent words.
Like, I could help you guys, but I'm not going to.
Pat Broderick. He also shared this with me, which is Fabrizio Aiello. I fouled as in the Spaghetti. Ah, Spaghetti. It's Fabrizio Aiello, who is the artist on Horace Hoover. I really do dig this art. I prefer it colored, though. I think his colors and the line art, really, it's like the joining of those two together make up more than the sum of the parts. He's got a great
orange. Do you have the colors?
I don't. I mean, I just got this. I'm just showing what John shared with me.
Mm.
Look, see, he says, thank you for showing that. I'm so excited. Horace H. Hoover. Do you say H or H?
I don't care. I mean.
I care. I judge people who say H. Harshly. Broderick was famous among other titles for Micronauts. Yeah, I'm just finding out about him. I like that he looks like he's from a Western. Horace the Hoover. That's great research. You know, I know nothing. I do like the look of this book, though. He really does fantastic colors. All right, moving on. This is cool. So Rini is doing something new. She's moving away from, I think, digital inks. She'll still be doing the thumbnails and initial pencils digitally, I think. But she's actually going to ink traditionally now. So she'll have traditional art, which is obviously very smart
move.
If you can do it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I can do that. But she can. And it looks to me, I mean, I'm not seeing any difference. I mean, it looks to me like her art. So... good on
it. Very, it looks digital.
And we know she'll make serious bank off traditional pieces, off art pages. It's like crazy. It's like printing money for her.
Yeah.
Not like us. Although I actually did pretty well. I shouldn't complain, but I always have to redo art. She's doing it from scratch. So that's cool. I remember her saying that. I didn't know that she had decided either way. That's cool. I hope it won't slow her down any. I know some people it actually speeds them up. Like, Ken Roquette, she would, digital slows him down.
She should do an Amazonian style book, just all females. That would kill.
She leans into the cheesecake. She does quite well with that. Moving to traditional, says Mo, is a solid temporary survival tactic in the face of AI. It's a very good point. It is a very good point. Yeah, it's like you have to get to the point now. We're all saying, yes, I hand drew this book with my hand. Everyone's having to say that now. And it's just the new world we live in. You'll like this one. Johnny is becoming a regular.
Mm.
You know, JP7 Art. He's becoming a regular. I saw him post this. So the pencils, I saw the full thing. Now he started inking it.
It's nice.
I thought you would appreciate that.
Nice ratio.
He is. Yeah. He kills it with the ladies. This is like a Victoria's Secret homage, maybe. But I've been loving the pages he's been throwing up recently. And I'm sure all of you out there.
I like how her finger Bancroft. You can tell she's a real proper lady because she's got a finger out like this.
Like this?
Yes.
Yep. I drink my tea.
Yes, exactly.
Captain Vipta says, I just thought Rini made languages, among other things. No, she can draw, that lady. Excellent proportions, says Art Bar.
Oh, yes.
Peter Gilmore's going to start drawing with his feet. Are you loving that nip right in the middle, Bancroft? Is that what that is? I thought that was lace. Oh, I thought that was, I guess that is a, do you reckon that's a nipple too? I thought that was lace as well.
It could be either.
I did see the nipple. That's why I didn't show the pencils, because I saw the nipple in the pencils. But then I thought, in the initial sketch, I thought he covered them up with some, you know, lacy, what is it? Negligee? Lingerie?
Hmm.
It's pointing at us. she looks like she's falling for that trick where you tell a girl to touch her elbows behind her back. She does it a little bit.
Hmm.
I remember that.
It's a great idea.
Hashtag justice for the nipple. All right. Check this out. Check out Eric Nieltowski. This guy is so funny. Look, here's a Prophet One sketch cover. Fun stuff. Just a fun nod to Liefeld and his amazing talent. Like, just a fun that's little sick. Nod.
That yeah, that's sick, dude.
People don't realize this stuff, what Eric is doing, what Shelby is doing, what others are doing, is actually, in my mind, in my humble opinion, actually superior to what was doing a lot of times, especially on the interiors back in the day. I think that, you know, the art has evolved. This style has evolved, even though it's obviously clearly evocative of that style. This is freaking crazy. And he just
it's just a cool character design too, isn't it? Like, yeah. Manly, so dude. 90s. That's cool.
So 90s. Yeah, he's a hell of a talent, and I hope I backed his book. His book is Shadow Sentry, in case anyone isn't aware. And it all looks like this. It's just really good. Really good. More splat than Rob, says Daniel Russell. I love that these guys are keeping that tradition alive. It just always comes back to the ladies. Here's another one. Leandro Oliveira. Leandro Oliveira.
I want to say Magdalene.
Just threw this up. Man, I do love pencils. We've got a, what do you call it? She's like a warrior priestess babe thing.
Yeah.
In traditional armored garb.
I reckon she's a nun.
She's a nun? You think that's a nun?
Yeah.
She's in the cemetery.
Yeah.
Out tending to the graves with a sword though and a staff or a spear.
She's checking to see if there's any fresh bodies that need her attendance.
I don't think she'd have any trouble getting the live bodies.
That's not what she's into.
It looks like it's set in times gone, you know, times past. She looks very well put together for those times, if you know what I mean. She would have had the pick of the litter. She looks a little Sydney Sweeney-esque, actually. That one's for Phil Diaz, who's obsessed with Sydney Sweeney.
Is he?
Yeah.
You're the one who's mentioned it multiple times this stream.
Yeah, just because he is so obsessed with it, that's all. Nothing mm-hmm. says warrior monk like almost being able to see her pubes. Yeah, she's well groomed as well for those days. The cemetery. What do you guys say? How do you guys say that word? How do you say it?
They probably have some weird name for it, like the body
cemetery.
Ground.
Cemetery. Oh yeah, cemetery. Right, of course. Let's go to see the cemetery. No, I say cemetery. I don't know if that's just me. I guess it's a bit like forehead.
Yeah, this is a nice piece. He does good work, this guy.
Yeah. Leandro, isn't it?
Yes.
Good stuff. Here's someone I found again. Oh, this looks Spanish.
I love this.
De Gabriel Rodriguez. That was a fail. This guy, I like this guy's style.
This is sick. More
sketchy.
Yeah, I like it.
It's cool, isn't it?
Yeah.
He shared the whole process from the pencil initial sketch right up to the inks and everything. It looks like there's some sort of beast behind her. And she's there with her killing axe that's been freshly used. She's a vampire of some kind. But also, you know, in looking nice in her repose. It's good stuff. It's like Sydney Sweeney's jugs have lifted the veil from Bancroft's eyes and he's no longer breastophobic. That accent was a hate crime. Someone call the Australian cops. I could actually get in trouble.
She has quite small boobs, Bancroft, and she still has a nipple. I just thought that's worth pointing out to you.
I think all boobs have nipples. It's just whether or not you choose to draw them.
Do they? I mean, according to you...
You don't have to show them all the time. That's the point.
Yes, they do. They do have a point. You don't draw it.
Yeah, that's a very Kelsey Shannon type boob. He loves that. Almost like you could rest a beer on it. Kind of perkiness.
I like her elongated fingers.
Yeah, I didn't notice that. Yeah, but she's a vampire.
Daniel says he draws lock and key. That's pretty cool.
Oh, does he? I never read that. I watched the first episode or maybe a couple of episodes and I don't know, I just didn't get into it. But people I know, I think Rini loves it. I might check it out. The wait staff have more convincing accents. What? Taco Bill? Where's my Taco Bill? This one?
After a big afternoon of shopping, there's nothing better than some Mexican food and a nice little drink. Come on down and enjoy a nice Mexican fiesta.
A nice Mexican fiesta. I love it. Sumo says it's a good book. All right, I'll check it out. I mean, usually, if they make a TV show out of it, it's going to be a good book. Usually.
Yeah. Doesn't mean it's going to be a good TV show, though.
Valley Law is pro nipple, but is that pro female or male nipple or both? Valley Law. Need some clarification on that. I'm not. This is the misunderstanding. I'm not against nipples. I just don't want to have two headlights poking out of Ella, distracting away from the story and the character. That's all.
Yeah. So we'll take a part of the female anatomy and remove it because that won't be distracting at all either.
Exactly.
Exactly. Okay, cool. That you makes sense.
Yes, it does. It does make perfect sense. Another one of my favorite artists out there, Ludo Lullaby, which I don't think is their real name, but I dig them. They do a whole range of different styles and stuff. Here's one that's a bit, I guess you could call this a bit more mangery. They do pencils and crazy stuff as well and everything. It's really cool, but I dig this. It's very, I like how, I guess I like the composition and the angle and everything and how it, you know, with the foreshortening and everything. It's pretty cool. I dig it. I really, really do.
I got a complete brain fade. What's that? What's the stuff he's used to shade it?
People call it zip tone. You can call it half tone.
I hate it. I hate it.
You hate it?
Yeah.
You hate it.
I hate it. I really do. I think it very rarely looks good. Like, I think it very rarely makes the piece look better than, you know.
I think it really adds to this piece because you get it. He's left it out in places and you get that shine.
I don't know. Think it's dope. Maybe it's just me.
That Mangari. Say that name again. It is. How do we get out of here? Ludo Lullaby. Ludo Lullaby. Is that, did I say that wrong? I don't know. I probably said it wrong. Valley Law for five again. Both. He doesn't discriminate. Male or female. We got Brad in the house. Says, I would mind being against some nipples. Yeah. Look, some nipples are hairier than others. Some nipples are too big for their own good.
It's
too much. It's too big. You know, it's like a chocolate chip cookie. And I'm not down for it.
What the fuck nipples have you been seeing, Mike?
Mangari, is that where Jesus was born? It was just around the corner. I like how the booty anchors the drawing and the figure. Yeah, exactly. I think it's a really cool piece. All right, moving on. This is great. Tyler Wendland. I just started following him. Artist and writer of The Red Koi and The Swan King. Look at this background.
Nice.
It is cool, isn't it?
Yeah, very nice.
A lot of effort has gone into this. I love that it's... I love people who can do backgrounds and it, you know, with straight lines and everything, but nothing is actually that straight. You can tell it's like hand-drawn and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool. And you got a little samurai up here.
Yeah, nice.
The shadows and everything. That is rad. Red Koi and... what is it? What are you saying? Red Koi and the Swan King. Maybe they're two different books. Shogun, Seat of Power. Shogun is... Samurai is very popular at the moment. It's getting around there. But that is really, really nice. I'm going to keep my eye out on this guy because I really dig that. I didn't even notice, actually, the hills in the background.
Have you been watching Shogun?
I haven't been watching anything. I haven't had time. I don't have time for TV shows and movies at the moment. Although I say that, we have done it the last two nights. That's only because it's been so friggin' hot. The kids have had to sleep in the living room because that's where the air conditioning is.
Jeez.
Red Koi is Alterna. Very nice. Cool artwork, says Winslow. Red Koi and the Swan King sound like antagonists in Whiteface Dick's lesser-known brush with the Japanese. Yeah, after that's he was done with so the Chinese. True. He went out to the... He went east. This was on the Graham Nolan art auction. This Spider-Man piece by David Williams, which I friggin' love.
Yeah, it's cool.
It reminds me of that classic cover that was in black and white of Spider-Man falling, and it was just the buildings. Very reminiscent of that. He has been crushing it lately, David Williams. He's been crushing the Greybeards. He crushed this. I friggin' love this. I would love to have a piece of art like that. You know, and it's a great take on this character. You know, the fact that he's put him on the light here and the light is hitting and just...
I think this might be my favorite piece so far.
Yeah, it's so cool. He's just...
It's just so different.
Out of the park. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. But it's also a throwback.
Yeah.
I can see, you know, the influences. It's sort of like a Ditko Spider-Man, and we've seen these black and white pieces before, but he just... The composition, everything... Look at this. He like the elbow juts out from there. Just everything about it. He just nailed it.
So
big, big shout out to David, who has been crushing it lately.
You should color it.
No. What? No. No colors. He's crushed the Greybeards. especially Fragile. Yeah. Do have to take it easy over there. He sold this. He sold this as for the Graham Nolan fundraiser.
Man, what did it go for? It's a good piece.
$700, I think, something like that. 900. Yeah. Speaking of a crusher,
dude, he's Roy. Killing it.
Roy,
what's he working on?
He's just doing pieces.
What the fuck, see, man?
Look at this fucking thing.
Ridiculous.
I think this is actually going to be a cover, by the way, which is crazy. You know, to go from doing a bit of fan art for people to this is one of the best Cyber Frogs. I would have said that was Ethan.
The style is very similar, like the details.
Yeah, but he does so much cool stuff, and he absolutely nailed these characters. There was a little bit of back and forth suggestions from Ethan actually along the way with his pencils and stuff, and he fixed sort of he made Cyber Frog wider. But the Sal is crazy. It looks like Heather. It's obviously a very sexy interpretation.
Gives me a little bit of Rob Willis vibes too.
Yeah, there's a little bit of that going there with the cross hatching and everything.
I love how his hands reflecting off their shoulder pad. That's cool.
Yeah, he did that too, which is not easy. Like a lot of people screw that up when they try it. Crushed it. Absolutely crushed it. Roy is... Man, I remember I saw his stuff originally. What the hell is this guy? And then I was like, oh, Roy, I'm going to put some pieces in the art share. And then I didn't. And then I started. And now it's been every single week there's another piece.
Dude, I got to get him to do something for me. That's amazing.
Yeah, reach out.
He's
getting it done. Mo says, Rob Willis, maybe working on one, should be finished in time for Cyber Frog 6. No, he's getting the covers out. And now I think Shinobi is being redone by someone else. So.
Oh, really?
I think so, yeah.
Jesus. Surely they'd just finish it with a different artist, like not redo the whole thing.
I don't know. Citizen Rain says that's his best piece to date. I agree. I mean, and it's the most, you know, it's the most work he's put into a piece that I've seen.
How long has he been doing art for? Like,
I would imagine a while.
Yeah.
He's named his avatar after art. It's like,
where is he?
He's in the chat.
How dare he not be here while we heap praise on his artwork?
Sometimes it's better that he's not, because then it seems like we're simping. Yes, he did the one with Sal jumping in the water too, which was a homage to Kelsey's piece. He's drinking Cyber Frog's milkshake.
Who wants to drink Heather's milkshake?
What? No. That would be... She is a human, Rob. No. Bad Rob.
Oh,
we get enough of that out there. We don't.
Yeah, that's the line, guys. Sorry.
Fantastic. Now, to this week, that guy died. Akira. Toriyama.
That guy.
Yeah. He made a cartoon or something, an anime. What manga?
Jesus, fuck, Mike. God,
the Dragon Ball Z guy. So a lot of people were posting Dragon Ball. Look, I'm not into Dragon Ball Z. I think I saw that movie.
The live action movie?
Yeah.
That's the one thing you want to see if you've never seen a Dragon Ball.
No, anything. Actually, back in the day, when Dragon Ball hit here in Australia really big, the toys were just everywhere. And I was stacking toys at Big W at the time. I knew all the characters. It was crazy. I had to. Yeah. when it came to Australia, I was too old. It was a kid's show and I was already a man at that point, stacking toys in a department store. So, but this is pretty rad. So here's Brett Booth. I don't know if he did these recently or he's just chucking them up because
oh, that's cool.
I know what it's about. You know, they go Super Saiyan. I know that.
Do you know
they fight each other?
Who's the character on the right, Mike?
That's the dragon boy.
Oh my god, this is amazing.
I would have known. No, seriously, I knew all the names back, but that was 1999. So it's a long time ago. That's 25 years ago, Rob.
I know Mo does not like manga, but I'm assume even Mo would know who that is.
Goku. There you go. Is it Goku?
Yes.
Yeah, I didn't. You know. But obviously, you know, there you go. Let's show some respect. How about a moment of silence and moving on to the next topic? Well, we're showing respect by showing off some cool art of the world. I'm sure it will continue on. And look, there was another one here.
Cool.
Yeah. I mean, Brett Booth is a freaking beast. There's also this one here by Dave Raposa, Eric Weather's favorite artist, which I guess is sort of like an Astro Boy-esque take.
Yeah, it's okay.
Oh, all right. I think he probably just threw this up. Yeah, he probably just did this in an hour after he learned that he died. So big respect there. All right. People have been posting art relating to some of the campaigns that are out there. So I thought I'd just share some of these. This is from Pump Kids, which is by our friend Kate, aka Nerium.
That's a big difference from her last book.
Oh, yeah, yeah. She's doing it. Well, it's a kid's book.
Oh, yeah.
So she's, I really dig the style. I think it's really fun, appropriate. It looks really cool. Something I'm sure the kids would very much get into. So yeah, really nice stuff. She's a talented artist, this one. I like that one. I like that. Look at that horse. It was a friendly horse.
I hate horses.
Is that some person who says it's a terrible title? Six Ways to Sunday. Yeah, they changed the title from Pump Kids to Pum Kids.
Pum Kids?
Yeah. So when you say it fast enough, it's like Pum Kids, as in pumpkins, but Pum Kids. You know? Anyway. Because originally it was Pump Kids, which was, yeah, people thought that was a little weird. But.
Yeah, let me be careful about pumping those kids, I think, is probably
that's not even touched.
I was bitten by a horse, some person, you're correct.
Bitten or kicked or something. Bitten. I don't want to put that link in there because I don't know if it's going to work. All right, well, let me just click on this and I'll put the link in. If anyone wants to go check it out, put the link there. We also have, the campaign of the moment, Iron Age Icons, all the mystery and intrigue and drama. He's shared the King Crypto, which I think is one of his best pieces, I'd have to say, on the campaign.
Yeah, it's nice.
This sort of stuff he really excels at. So he's got that there. And yeah, there was a little bit of a kerfuffle over She, but it's all been sorted out. He's going to add a different one instead of She on there, but it did get funded. So congratulations to Adam.
Nice.
45 backers there. Put that in there. If you want to go support him there. I got mine. This is cool. Travis Gibb, who I think is a writer. I don't know who the artist is on this. Let's find out. Publisher.
Is he a sane person or an insane person?
I don't know. I just like the art. Roland's Kalnins. It could be the artist. I just thought this was cool. I just dug it. Yeah. I don't know what it is. Don't know what it's about. Coins of Judas. The title's pretty cool. Anyway, it's on Kickstarter at the moment. If you like the look of that art, I think it's pretty cool. Go check it out.
It's nice.
It is a nice piece, says Jeremy. Yes, I agree. Good art on this. Coins of Judas. That's an interesting thing. So, like, you use the, I'm guessing, you know, there's the, what is it, 30 pieces of silver. Have you ever wondered what happened to the 30 pieces of silver that Judas dropped when he betrayed Christ? The Westergaard family knows, and they have been fighting a hidden war against demons that have spawned from it for years. Cool concept.
All right. I did not know any of that.
Well, it's a story. You don't know about the 30 pieces of silver?
No.
You heathen.
I am.
Shanthan Jetty. Well, I was going to say hi to Shanthan Jetty, whose piece is the thumbnail piece tonight. Hail Shanthan Jetty, who did finish that painting to end all paintings, which we will be looking at shortly, Shant. Thank you so much. And Sumo Thori, the absolute mad lad, has just gifted 5 memberships. Thank you so much, Sumo. I'm going to give you the mad lad.
Absolute mad lad!
Boom. Blowing out the eardrums, gifting memberships, Gusto, Marcus, Jolly Green, Lieutenant Hughes, and Robert H., all new members. Thank you so much, Sumo. Thank you, thank you. All right, what was I up to here? This is cool. I had this guy on the show, Project Naosis.
That's cool.
And this is showing off here the Virgin cover from his campaign here, which is, yeah. I thought you would like this. This is kind of your similar character design.
It's right up my alley. It's like, I like, yeah, the, like, character design.
Machinery and weird stuff, yeah, on the cool, face, man. Teeth and everything. Yeah, yeah. And he's a really cool dude, just out there getting work done. He goes to a lot of conventions. That's sort of his bread and butter. He sells his stuff at conventions, but he is doing crowdfunding now, and it's doing really well for him. So good on him. Good looking stuff. Our very good friend Mr. Luke Stone Studios, he says he had a lot of fun working on this for Dan Stevens. Stained Glass will be coming to crowdfunding soon. Stained Glass, I don't know what that is, but we can guess it's some kind of angel, maybe angel demon battle war thing. Check out, you would like that sword, Rob. Love that.
Makes me feel like a real man.
This could be me. This could be Michael. This could be my namesake. We don't know. But it looks like he's losing his wings, that blast here.
Yeah. Jake Martin.
Oh my goodness. Jake, thank you so much. Another 5 memberships. Jake, let's tell you this one.
You little ripper!
Thank you. How's your father? Vincent Cam, Rusty Trousers. I like that. And the Soul Colliery Alt, all new members here. That's an angry angel, says Citizen Ronan. Could be Gabriel.
So this must be when Satan. When the 88 angels fell to earth. Yeah.
Could be. Yeah. I always was really intrigued in that, and I didn't know where all that story came from, like where you can actually read it. I don't think it's in the Bible. I know a lot of it's in literature and from other sources and stuff like that. I would be very interested in a kind of a storytelling of that. I don't know if that's what this is. But anyway, Luke Stone, it looks like he's the artist, or he's doing art for it. He did a piece for it. So anyway, stay tuned. Coming soon. Stained Glass. It's in Genesis, is it? Really? Is it all in Genesis? Can't remember. Anyway, I'll take your word for it. Ollie, our good friend Ollie, on one of my favorite books of all time, Cryptidnals, is doing that. Looks like they're doing a Kickstarter of Cryptidnals, or it's just okay. It's a dead stop one, and they're doing sketch cards on it. You can pick up a sketch card. I love Cryptidnals. I love this style, and this is by Dario. Dario Rodriguez.
Very nice.
Yeah, I dig it. It's so right for this story. You know, scary and spooky and creepy and cool stuff. So you can go if you want a sketch card, go and hit up this Kickstarter. I'll put the link. Get yourself a Dario Kickstarter. Grab yourself Dead Stop Tour of Terror while you're at it. The Book of Enoch, the Book of Mormon, the Book of Revelation. It's all in there, apparently. And Aaron Lopresti, check this out. Have you back Kit Carter yet, Planet Doom? Page 32 pencils. He says he's about halfway done. This guy is an absolute maniac.
Yeah, beast.
He is pretty much a draughtist in the interiors, which is that's another level. Aaron is going all out on Kit Carter. I think I'm going to have to grab this. I just recently received Wraith of God. I haven't read it yet. I'm sure I'm going to love it. I just haven't had time as yet. But yeah, I think I'm going to jump onto Kit Carter as well. I love Kelsey's colors. The art on this looks incredible. Prayers to the Inca, says Citizen.
Yeah, that's sick.
Tell me about it. And the colorist too.
Yeah.
It's like, wow, Aaron is very fast. Yeah, he's getting it done. I said there's we were talking about the Euro books on a show yesterday, and I was like, Shane, Aaron, Graham, Kenneth. I was on the chat, and I think someone else in this space, especially, connected in Comicsgate, are really embracing the European method of getting a book out a year and actually getting it done. So, you know, big shout out to that. And I aspire to that. I'm not there yet, but Graham.
Yeah. I love how he's put X's in the mouth for the Inca, even though they're all black.
Just to be sure.
Just in case you weren't sure, guys, yeah, make sure that's black. That's great.
And up here as well.
Yeah.
But hang on, he's got it here too. Surely that wouldn't be black. Like, I don't know. Maybe it is. I don't know.
Sure, his colorist is Kelsey. It's going to be fire.
Oh, dude, you should see it. Yeah. It is. So the inker is Matt Ryan. The colorist is Kelsey. Kelsey's colors are just mind-blowing. I think the whole thing is it's crazy. So I'll put the link in for that in case you haven't got it yet. Kit Carter. I need to grab it. There it is. Oh, 1,200 back. It's good on him. Speaking of, Nexus Scourge coming on all platforms. This is Kelsey. This is Kelsey art and colors.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
I love this. I love what he's doing. And I showed off a whole suite of pages a couple of weeks ago. And they look amazing. Look at this. That's cool. He is just too good. Look at these shots, these up shots. Now, we know how difficult that is.
Yeah.
He's just crushing it. I can't wait for this one. Everything I've seen from this looks amazing. I've read four books from Mike Baron. Each one of them has been fantastic. So
what's happening here, though, in this story? Something, a planet?
It looks very unusual. I don't quite know. I've never read Nexus before, but it looks very out there, and I like that. I'm into that. I want to read something that's a bit out there. So, it's cool. I don't think I have a link for that one, but I mean, it'll be everywhere. It'll be everywhere at the time. This is something I just stumbled across. I think we've shown this before, but I couldn't remember. It's from Sentinel Creatives, which is an account I follow. I get a lot of cool art from. It's not anything that doesn't look like we can get it now, maybe at his website, but he says he's shipping out digital rewards for something called Folkloric. Did you guys? I feel like this is familiar, but he says it's all things anthology of folk horror. Cool. Which I know a lot of you guys will be into. And this art looks great.
Yeah,
it's like Pan's Labyrinth, you know? Just super creepy and gross. And I love that color palette. I don't know who the artist is. I don't know anything about it. Jav just got his Loosen update. Cool, I'll show that at the end. Totally sick. Dean loves it. Yeah, it's cool. I just saw it. I was like, I got to share this. Look at this gross rabbit thing.
It's great.
I'm sure if Peter Gilmore's still here, I'm sure he'll love that as well.
Oh, there's
even a nip slip.
Oh my god, run for the hills. Oh, that's cool. Cool title.
Yeah, folkloric.
With that mango rat on it.
Yeah.
Looks sick.
So yeah, I don't know what the, I don't know what it is, but it looks like it's coming out. It's probably a Kickstarter, but yeah, anyway, the guy has a website. It's called sentinelcreatives.net. Let me click on that. Put that in there. I know you might be able to get the Peter Gilmore is here, and he says, "Yep, it looks cool." So check that out. Pilgrim. There you go. I don't know anything. I know nothing. But go check him out. Cranberry says that looks gorgeous, looks great. All right. I remember all the Wolverine Wolverine and Beast remakes, because they had that cover that was just fell completely flat and everyone was redrawing their own version of it.
Mm-hmm.
And Dan Dahl did a version which I thought was probably the best. And now it's been colored by Samuel Diaz.
Yeah, cool.
Do you remember this one?
No.
Do you remember? Yeah, Cassidy. And it was just, it really didn't work. It didn't look good. The foreshortening was all off. And Dan Dahl did a crazy one. I remember we looked at the pencils or the inks or something. Anyway, someone's colored it. And Samuel Diaz.
It's nice.
Speaking of Diaz, the Lost Pages is going to print. Lost Pages 3. So everyone looks forward to that.
Doesn't muck around, that kid.
Getting it done. I don't know how he's getting it done with all his, you know, just staring at Sidney Sweeney all day, but he's figured it out. Yeah, great piece there. Really cool. Good job, Samuel. What is Mo saying? Bancroft said he never read Nexus, and then Gate kept my joke that Red Nexus is the Nexus Florida Man crossover. Oh, no. Then I apologize, Mo. That's my bad. Red Nexus is the crossover with Florida Man. Okay. We've got Raiden Radio in the house. That in Australia, folk horror is the guy that lives down the road. You're not wrong.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
You are not wrong. Look, there he is. Yeah, man, we're super excited for Lost Pages 3. It looks crazy. He showed off. It's funny. He was showing off the book, but it was through Mixum. You know how they do like a preview? And half the pages were blank. But it was just a loading error, but we were all having fun with it. It's funny. Speaking of Wolverine, I don't know, someone just shared this. Some pretty badass Wolverine art. I thought you would love this. I think this is something that you would love to do in Replicator.
Yeah, I reckon this is... I know we're not meant to say this, but I reckon this is AI.
Yeah, I could be. I don't know.
But yeah, it's sick. It's great.
I just wanted to show it to you because I thought you should definitely do something in Replicator.
I love these character concept sketch type things. I love them. They're like my favorite. They just look great.
Yeah, it's funny. It's weird. I just thought exactly of you when I saw this.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, I don't know if it's AI. It just says some badass Wolverine art I found.
Yeah.
I don't know. Could be for something. He seems to be missing one muscle. Says, yeah, they didn't do the, you know, dissection around here.
Maybe it looks like it might just pop out of there.
It's tucked in.
Like you press a button and it comes out, maybe.
All right. Here we go. Ready? Drum roll. I actually literally have a drum roll.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Cloudburst Cantana by Shanthan Jetty. 12.5 by 18.5 inches, painted with acrylic on illustration board, commissioned by yours truly. It is done. # Comicsgate, # Iron Age, # give nihilism no quarter. I didn't notice this originally. He signed it on both the top and the bottom.
I'm amazed that you paid someone else for something.
What do you mean? I pay everyone. I have paid a lot of people for art for the Lucent. I haven't done anything with it yet, but I will. And what am I going to do with this, Rob?
This is a great piece, dude. There's so much going on in it.
And it's because he actually had a very early kind of draft of the art. Look, he's even got the undies in here, Ella's underwear and the on the bike here. So he actually gleaned a lot of this stuff from Painter Death. And I would have sent that to him probably 6 months ago, maybe a bit longer. So obviously it's really developed since then. But so much of this stuff, man, Shanth really, really gets the Lucent. He really understands it.
Got my favorite character in there, Mike. Man with bicycle helmet on.
Man with bike helmet. Who could it be? Oh, my goodness. It's like the Replicator. Who could it possibly be? No one knows. It's like who's Darth Sidious in Star Wars? Who, I mean, it's just, it's Bancroft nice specified frogs. No nipples. That is true. There are no nipples here, as far as I can see. We've got the frog in there.
Yeah, it's nice.
The dude coming out of the red. I like how he turned the red gloopy blood into flame that goes into her hair. And it as well, he got the... See, he did this on his... This wasn't discussed. He did this. He was like, I feel like the Lucent is sort of like a reflection of two worlds on sacked on top. I was like, dude. And he just now he's got like Ella coming down here and Utnapishtim coming up here.
So good that you didn't give him any direction, Mike, because who knows what he would have done.
I know, right? Look, the skull in here.
No, that's great, dude. That's a top piece.
I mean, it's
I love the this part, I think, is the best with the stairs and the water, like how
Up. How that comes up and then blends in.
Yeah, that's amazing.
And he sort of reflected it over here, and then that stair there is where Gilgamesh passes out from exhaustion.
It needs to be like a cover, like a hardcover cover of some sort.
Yeah, I don't know. It'll clearly be a poster. It'll be available as a poster. It'll be available as a puzzle. But then do I just make another book and offer it as a cover? I guess. Yeah.
Pretty fucking good.
You want it oversized.
Yeah.
Maybe like with no writing on it, because I wouldn't put, I don't think I'd put the Lucent over it.
Nah.
It could be a virgin cover. It's either way. I mean, he went so far above and beyond on this one. And even he knows that. It's crazy.
Yeah, that's a wicked piece, dude.
I remember it was because he started sketching it and drawing it just on a stream one day. And I was like, oh my God, can this be a thing? And so I ended up commissioning him to do like an actual full painting of it. And I remember I said to him, I love that one that you did for Jake. For Zade Studios. And for Beckend. And damn. Increase the price if you do, says Cranberry Langus. Yeah, we're not sure. I mean, I've got the crowdfunders coming up for this for once my book is done. Once the book is done, I'll be throwing it up onto all the crowdfund sites, so maybe it'll be an exclusive there. I just got to figure out how to do it so that people have already backed don't have to pay shipping twice, which is very difficult with these sites. So
that's really cool.
Yeah. Speaking of Jake, we got Hyper in the house. I would agree. It would make a great puzzle. It's not all blues. Yeah, it would make a perfect puzzle. It's probably make the best puzzle that I would have put out ever. So, yeah. Special edition, Waking Dream, upside down, Painted Death, the other. That's an idea. You do that up, so you have to turn it around. I don't know. We'll figure out something. I own it. I have the printing rights.
How much are you selling the piece for?
I don't have the actual thing. That's for Shanth.
Oh.
A Lucent deck of cards? That's interesting. I did ask him how much he might consider selling the original for. He didn't get back to me, but he might not be there yet, and that's fine. Moses, hear me out. A magnet. Yeah. Now, speaking of people in the chat with extraordinary levels of talent, this man right here, unassuming Citizen Ronan. Look at him there, just saying hi to Jasper. Citizen Ronan's got a painting in process here. He's doing Jimmy Stewart to add to his portrait portfolio. Look at this guy. Look at what he can do.
It's pretty good.
I think this is oil too. Mm. Oil on canvas. Absolute mad lad. The talent in the chat that we're just not fully aware of until they decide to kind of come out. Have their coming out moment and let us know the skills that they have. Super impressive, Citizen Ronan. Super impressive. Everyone is in agreement. Awesome. Doilies? I should do doilies? Do doilies.
Do I want to admit this or not, Bancroft?
What do you want to admit?
I have no idea who this guy is.
Jimmy Stewart?
Yeah.
He's an old actor.
Oh.
From the bygone days. Mm. The olden days. Do you have a TV show? You guys would know. I don't really know. Mike, send me Sydney Sweeney's stuff. All right. Send it around. Whenever I see it. I mean, it's kind of a joke now. Whenever I see her, I just send her to Phil. It's a Wonderful Life. There you go.
No, I haven't seen it.
Rob hasn't seen it. Well, I haven't seen a lot of things either, so I can't really berate him. That would be unfair of me. Here's something interesting I saw.
Oh, Rear Window. I've seen Rear Window. Yeah, okay, I remember. Yeah.
Oh, my God. I've totally forgot. Hold on a sec. Where is it? Don't act like you don't know the Australian pastime of spying kangaroo Eiffel Towers. It's called an Aussie roundabout. How's your father? Just be glad people recognize Jimmy Stewart to begin with. Exactly. It's kangaroo threesome. Kangarootin. Oh, my God. That's brilliant. Peter says, that's not the Skippy I remember. That's what's happening outside of Rob's rear window right now.
All the time.
He lives out there. He sees them. I didn't get him here in civilization, but Rob lives out. He's a country folk.
I also have an army of magpies at my disposal.
Well, I have them as well. Well, there's a whole family of them around here making a racket. But anyway, a lot of people are kind of doing this older style. It's almost, what do you call it? It's not really golden age, more silver age, maybe towards bronze on their books. And I'm down for it. I dig it. I don't know what this is. Cover of Russ versus Lizards. I've got no idea what it is. It all looks very weird to me, but I like it. I like the colors. I like the style. I like the throwback, but, you know, it seems new.
Best color in the world right there.
What's that?
Orange.
Orange?
Yeah.
I prefer the blue. I prefer the teal. But they work well together. Anyway, I just dig this. Axley. I don't know the artist. Cool. It's cool, isn't it? And I saw another one too. Same guy, actually Gorbot. Same guy. I'm gonna follow this guy. You know, remember when Pablo Romero came out doing that, this sort of vintage style?
Yeah, vintage.
Really worked quite well. It's something about the colors, I think. It's obviously the art is quite simple, but it really works with the colors. The sort of thing that I would love a print of.
We know why you like this piece, Mike.
No why is that?
Nicholas.
Citizen Ronan, he loves it too. Oh, Jasper, I want a Graham Nolan head sketch this week. Oh, that's awesome. He's to donate towards his daughter's apartment fire fund. Excellent. Everyone, please do. I donated towards that. I hope everyone did as well. I think he's raised a ton of money for his daughter and her husband. So that's awesome. I can't even imagine having to start. It's a thing that happens. Remember that happened to, I think it was Mike Murphy and Selena. I think, don't quote me on that. Happened to someone that they lost their. Oh no, was it? I totally forget. What was that girl's name? Remember, she had a kid. She was doing a book. She is an artist.
That fucking narrows
this
it down.
Is stretching. No. This is stretching the memory back. She was cool. I haven't thought of her in years.
A woman with a kid who
she
did
had
art.
Long blonde hair.
She had hair.
Yeah, she had
amazing.
a kid.
Oh my god, guys. How do you not know who this is?
No, I hadn't thought about her in years. She was hanging around a lot, and then I guess she just sort of went off and became a mum, and I don't know. No, it's not Mandy. No, it's not Mandy. Yeah, see, Mo Big. I know who Bancroft means, but I don't remember her name either. Not Barb.
Yeah.
Oh, this is gonna kill me. Come on, guys. Some OGs out there. You remember her? It was a husband and wife team. I see a book. There was a dragon. I see a dragon. Who was this?
Carla, Eva.
It's gonna kill me. It's not Beer.
It's a Beer Rose.
Anyway, I guess you're just going to have to move on. Oh, this is going to... Carla, thank you. Oh, and it needs a spaghetti. Oh, Carla Tortellini. Thank you. Yes, that would have killed me. Thank you, Metal Movies and Brucey's. I knew there were some OGs in here.
You should give him a super chat for that.
B-Rose had heartburn, not a fire. Yes, reading all those super burritos. Yes. Was it a wolf book, not a dragon? Tonielli, not Tortellini. Oh, God, that would have, you know, you get those things and you just can't remember. And that Carla was cool. I wonder what she's up to. I hope she's doing well. She was a really good artist.
I like pink in the background here. It's nice.
Yeah, no, exactly. I think it's the colors that set it, you know, above. It was about death. It was Witch Hunter. Okay, we're still waiting for it. All right. I guess people will probably follow up on that. I don't know. I can't remember. I haven't been keeping tabs on it. I totally haven't been thinking about it. But yeah, she was cool. Another cemetery. Big foreheads in the cemetery. She does K-pop stuff now. All right. Now this one. I need to get into my... I'm thinking it's going to be Russian. Yevgeny Sokolov is doing art. And he did this ink, watercolor, pencil on Bristol paper of Colossus. And we've got some Deadpool. We've got some Juggernaut. It's pretty cool. What do you think? You're not a fan. You don't like
it. I think Deadpool can die in a fire. I'm sick of him already.
I'm not talking about the characters. I'm talking about the art. I think it's interesting. It's a new style. Yeah. It's not your thing?
Not my thing. No. I mean, it's not bad. It's just not
bad. Not your thing. Fair enough. Yevgeny. I just like saying his name. Yevgeny Sokolov. I'm sure that's exactly how it's pronounced too. Juggernaut's costume is the wrong color. Maybe it's a work in progress. I don't know. Everyone, some
Raven Radio. The color on Juggernaut makes him look like a scrotum.
Jesus, you guys are harsh.
Yeah, it's great though,
fair.
Isn't it?
Harsh but fair. All right. I mean, I just thought I've been trying to find some new artists to show you guys. You know, see what you think. Test the waters.
It's Scrotum Juggernaut. It's weird because it looks like Scrotum. He's like colored over pencils. Is that what it is, Mike?
It's colored over pencils. Juggernaut. It's Juggernaut. Ah. Yeah. Well, it's a mix. It's a mixed media piece. He said that ink, watercolor, and color pencil minimal.
Yeah.
Color
pencil. I think that might be why.
Maybe it's a work in progress. I don't know.
Angela says she's driving.
Don't crash, Angela. Don't crash. Definitely. Jake Martin says, yes. It's like he's tasting. Yes, some definite scrotal tones in there.
Oh, shit.
God, that reminds me of a Dave Chappelle sketch, which I die. He's doing a CSI guy, and he's like walking around the scene. And he slips on something and he's like, shine a torch down here. It's like, it's glistening in the light. You've got, I'm not gonna do the whole bit. If you're aware of that piece, you'll know what I'm talking about. It's a fantastic set. It's a fantastic joke that Dave Chappelle does. Takes balls to show this piece.
Mike just wanted to give this artist a little bit of a spotlight, and now his work's getting called Scrotum.
I know. Anyway, who's another artist I want to shine a little highlight on here? South Korean artist by, okay, how do you say South Korean? That's a like, I'm thinking a Gangnam Style. Woppa Gangnam Style. Why you on here? I got to get in character first. I got to do what I know first.
And you just set your racism meter to 11.
I did. What do you mean? I'm trying to honor them.
Uh-huh.
I'm trying to be accurate. Check this out. This is some spooky, weird, creepy. This is great, though, isn't it? Look. So she's in bed with the severed head of her king. And it looks like she's probably a princess. It could be her father. Because why else would you have a severed head in your bed staring face to face with you? And then you got all the people who are conspiring to take her kingdom from her. I don't know. Either way, it's rad. I dig it. I don't know what's going on here though. It's a bit weird.
This is the weird piece out of the two.
the fuck? So like the sword of Damocles, but he's already dead and he's chained up. I like the red hair though. I don't know. I appreciate it. It's cool art. I don't know. Nice. I have no idea what any of it's about, but you know, these South Koreans, who knows what they're up to? Up there. Is it over there?
I feel like
they're directly above us, aren't they, South Koreans? Raiden says, I can fix her. She's after some rock hard head. The first piece is really cool. Yeah, more like the first. I agree. I think that was the one that drew my eye. Norman Rockwell Nightmares. Yeah, it's cool. Haven't shown some pixel art in a while. This one is really nice. Night Shift by Killer Rabbit. We've got a bit of a caboose here. And look, he's taking a little...
What do you guys think of pixel art?
I love it. Love it. There's something about it. It's magic. I think it's the limited color palette, the limited, what do you call it? Definition. There's something about, you got to, you know, there might be a little bit of nostalgia with me, you know, going back to Monkey Island and stuff like that. But I can't get enough of it. Hold on. I skipped over a sumo comment.
Is that where you were born?
Say his name again, please. Was that it? You want me to say the South Korean name? All right, let me get back into character. Whoopa Gangnam Style, are you Aeon Hugh? How about that? Is that? I don't know. But this is Killer Rabbit. Killer Rabbit M. I don't think that's his birth name. Yeah, I dig it. I think this is really cool. I do like some, you know, orange highlights in the blue, in the moonlight. Bancroft Sumo wants you to read the previous artist name again and for Rob to say emotional damage. Is that punishment? I think the first name is Ryu.
No. I mean, that makes more sense.
Agree to disagree. We can agree to disagree on that. Do you want to say emotional damage for old time's sake? No.
I'll do it when it's appropriate.
$10 from CMA 30. Worth every penny. Well, I'm here to help. I'm here to entertain. Thank you so much, Sumo. $10. Okay, you get one of these, Sumo.
Well, cheers, big ears.
Had Bancroft made a remark about my caboose? No, just this caboose. We read the I read Clark the caboose book, you know, that golden book the other day. Let's just play a clip of Rob saying it. I'll go find it. Good, you do that, Rob. I called Mo Rob. I'm never gonna live that down. One last piece to go. And this is cool. I see these guys out there on the street doing this. This is a particularly good version of it. You know, they do these paintings that look like it starts off like a Jackson Pollock, but then it actually ends up being something good. Have you seen those guys?
I've seen this, yeah.
Yeah, Paul Kenton. I thought this is nice. I like this stuff. What? What are you laughing at? Bancroft, what the F? Apologize. I apologize sincerely, Mo. I didn't mean that, obviously. Clearly, I want to smear you with that.
Now you've been infected, Mo. It's too late.
Scarlet letter. Horrible. All right, let's watch this. I like these guys. It's sort of like the new... What's that? Who's that artist everyone loves? With the puffy hair?
Bob Ross.
It's like a technique that I think everyone could probably do, but... This guy just does it particularly well. Just a few splatters.
Yeah, I'm sure everyone could just go out and do this, Mike. What are you talking about, you crazy monkey?
I mean, with practice, you know, it doesn't look like it's particularly... You would get better at it, surely. But
Peter says, do you mean Rolf Harris?
No. I do not mean Rob Harris. It's cool, isn't it? I mean, it really does look like a city. I see. This is sort of art that people do out on the street live because you can do it and then they sell it. Although I don't know how you take it home. Surely it would be wet. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, it's sick.
Would you hang that in your house?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I think so too. I like it. And I like that, you know, it's full of impasto and yeah, I dig it. Kirby Langer says, gorgeous, gorgeous. Hyperwizard says it's AI. It's Moby Dickulous, says Sequential. All right, I got something to play here from Mo as a form of apology.
God, how bad is this going to be?
It's going to be bad for you. I have no idea what this is, but here we go. Chrome tab sharing audio. Good, good. All right, let's see what this is. This is, I guess, to make up. I don't know how we take it home. Certainly would it be wet. That's why Rob stopped clapping. My God. Embrace it, Rob. All right. Embrace this, Rob. Whatever it is, embrace it.
Earth made an Australian video, and I wasn't even in it.
Ah. Emotional damage.
Oh, I got to play that again. That's you because you got a Rob Hawk.
Is oh, my play? God.
Ah, that's the wrong one. What happened?
Earth made an Australian video, and I wasn't even in it.
Emotional damage.
How am I not seeing that before? I am adding that to my videos to play. Oh, my God.
How bad was it? That was amazing.
Beautiful. The mighty scrotum. Oh, my God. That was beautiful. I am downloading that right now. How have I not seen this? Oh, it's not letting me. I'll do it later. That's it. Oh, actually, so it looks like everyone's gotten their emails. Progress update number 7. Let me open this up. Where are we? Sharing the screen. Take down the mighty scrotum comment off the stream.
He sounds like he's from East LA.
I mean, it's something. It really is. I don't know how you managed to get that out of that meme, but you did. Progress update number 7. So yeah, obviously, like I said, couldn't finish the 24 pages, but they're very close to being done. I'm moving on to the line art now, just so I get knock that out of the way. So yeah, this green here, even though it's like 90% done, and you know, I'll just be able to knock all that out in a week or two. And yeah, I'm just sharing some new.
Oh, that's nice. I like that.
New pieces, new panels.
Skull Will.
Yep. The what do we call it? The someone gave a name for it. I did note it down because I knew I'd forget it. The well of souls. How cool is that?
What about skull vagina?
I'm gonna stick with well of souls.
I love the colors on that mic though. The oranges and browns you got going through that. It's really nice.
Yeah, it's good, doesn't it? It works well. I actually colored that live one night. Late.
Wow.
Late at night.
That's impressive.
Remember, we drew this one live, if you remember. Some interior shots here. I finally got the red highlight in because that was like,
did you?
I was like, I want a red highlight.
It's pretty orange.
It's red.
You got to turn that red up a little bit.
It's red. It might just be the screen share. Where I'm sitting, it's red. It's red enough. But I'm definitely going to be doing more of it. I want to incorporate that more. But I needed an excuse. And this is like I said, okay. Well, the inside of helicopters sometimes is a red light. So I thought, oh, that's a cool thing. It's just stepping out of a helicopter.
The whole piece looks good.
The which one?
The whole piece.
Yeah. I'm really happy with how that came out too. So that's the hallway in without just the light coming in from the outside.
And she's coming out of the closet?
She's coming out of she was in here when the light was on.
Oh, okay.
A lot of different ways to do this here. And so all coming together. 69,525 raised, getting very close to finished. Kirby Langus is impressed. Thank you so much. It's Aaron Lopresti Chinese red. Exactly. It's a good red.
So that's your brown level, I take it.
What do you mean by brown level?
Your brown level.
Oh, this one?
Yeah.
Well, it's sort of a aubergine dark purple reddish hallway, and there's lots of brown. Well, there's wood in there. So, yeah. Well, it has to differentiate from the different rooms. And I colored it red because there's something that happens, some murder and mayhem that happens out here. And I wanted it to be red.
More kids?
Reflect that. No. Well, a young man.
Oh, okay.
Come to a ignominious end.
Looks good, dude.
Yeah, I'm happy with it. It's all coming together. It's grandpa's 70s house. It is grandpa's big mansion. So but anyway,
it's so funny when you go to an old person's house, though. Like, they're all the same. They all have like a glass cabinet with like plates and stuff in it. They all have those little doilies just sitting on furniture for some reason.
Well, you know, you show off your what you've accumulated over the years.
Yeah.
Who's being taken to Brown Town? We have to get the comic to find out. Thank you, Ray. All right, everyone. I think that's going to be it. Do you have anything you want to say, show, share?
No.
No. All right. That's okay.
Soon.
Our Luniverse loves the art, especially with the glass. Yeah, I'm really happy with how that whiskey decanter came out with the reflection. I really wanted to do that. And it worked well. Okay, I'm off for a couple of days. Who's streaming? Who wants a raid? I think the Slumlord's alive. Let's send everyone over there. Yep, and looking. All right, we'll probably send everyone over there. Customize, redirect. There we go. Done and done. Rob, you are dismissed. Thank you so much for coming and hanging out. Did you enjoy the art tonight? It seemed a bit hit and miss for you.
It was a bit hit and miss. I mean, it's nowhere near as good as when I do it, but that's
I okay. like to show what people are sharing out there, whereas you go and hunt art out. It's a different thing.
Yeah, like, I go and do work. You have people bring you food. I'm the hunter. You're the person that doesn't collector. Hunt.
All right. Anyway, all right. That's it. I'll see you guys later. Have a good night. See you around. Bye.
Individually, we are weak, like a single twig. But as a bundle, we form a mighty fact. Thank you.